working on these days, Sugith?
I'm shooting season 2 of Transplant for CTV and NBC. We shoot that in Montreal, so I go back and forth, but I'm glad to be working.
And are you getting lots of work?
Well, I mean, I repair on Transplant, so it's keeping me employed, if nothing else, and I'm grateful. And it's
sure.
It's a really good show. It beat its time slot on NBC, and it was a number one drama in Canada the first season one. So I'm glad that, you know, I was on Kim's Convenience for 5 seasons, and that ended prematurely, so that I'm sort of still grieving over that, but
yeah.
I'm glad to have Transplant as my fallback.
And what's it called?
Transplant.
Yeah.
It's on NBC and on CTV in Canada.
Oh, good.
And it's a big hospital show. I play Dr. Singh, the senior surgeon who crushes dreams.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I wouldn't mind having a look at it. I watch too much hockey, Sugith.
Well, it streams on, you're in the States, it streams on Peacock TV in the States for free, and it streams on CTV.ca and Crave Canada in Canada, and then season
yep.
2 probably will start in the fall on NBC and CTV, you know, for free. So, I mean, it's a really popular show. I'm very lucky.
Where did you shoot it?
It's set in Toronto at a fictional
okay.
hospital called York Memorial, but we shoot it in Montreal. They built an incredible set, a hospital set on a soundstage in LaSalle, which is just outside Montreal.
Sure.
And this is the most amazing set I've ever been on. You know, I've been on a lot of sets in my career, and you can always tell you're on a set. But once you walk into the soundstage of this hospital, it's a hospital. Everything works.
Yep.
The walls don't move. The floor is a real floor, and the operating room is a real operating room, and everything works. The only thing that doesn't work is the plumbing. And in fact, they, you know, you can find videos of this set. Bill Brew, who's a big TV reporter, writer, who visited the set once, and he's been on the set of ER and House and Grey's Anatomy, and he said this one's bigger than all of them. So it's a really good show. The production values are top notch, and you know it's a Canadian show, and it's like, I think it's something for us to be proud of as a TV industry, because it's really, and the writing, you know, that's what it boils down to. The writing is fantastic.
That's great.
Is there anybody from across the border? Is it all Canadian talent?
John Hanna from The Mummy and 4 Weddings and a Funeral, he's one of our series regulars, but everybody else is homegrown.
Well, that's good. That's even more impressive.
I think it's going to be up for some awards, season 1.
Good.
In fact,
it is
up for awards for the Canadian Screen Awards.
Oh, yeah, good.
But I think it might even have a shot at an Emmy.
So are you? Is it got American distribution?
NBC Universal. So NBC Universal put it on NBC.
Is it a primetime show?
Primetime, 10 o'clock. 10 o'clock Tuesday nights.
That's a good time slot. Well, it's not prime time quite. On that night, prime time would be from 7 to 9 p.m.
No, it's 8 to 10. 8 to 11 is prime time. 8 to 11, and we're at the same time slot as Law and Order and those kinds of shows. It's not opposite Law and Order, but it's consistently won its time slot. Season 1 won its time slot on NBC. So it got renewed, and we're back, and we're filming now. And
So how are they doing the filming right now?
Well, you know, it's a whole new world with COVID, right?
Is everybody in the cast and crew vaccinated?
I don't know if everybody's vaccinated. We're all, you know, tested and medically cleared, and we have to. We in Quebec, they have different rules than Ontario for filming, and the rules in Quebec are that if you're declared stable Team 1, which I am, you have to you know, warrant that you're not exposed on another show for 7 days prior to shooting on that show. And everybody on set is wearing face shields and masks. And, you know, there's guys with COVID officers walking around with 2-meter-long sticks and 1-meter-long sticks, measuring everybody in terms of how the scene is even blocked. So a lot of
how do they do any of the intimate scenes?
Well, that's the challenge now in season two, is they have to figure out how to shoot a scene. We're doctors, right? We're supposed to be close to the patient. They have to figure out how to shoot it. It just doesn't
make sense to me, because the set should be, everybody should be like there's such a fucked up, it's so fucked up, all of the different criterias for different levels. Like, if you take a look at the hockey players, they don't have masks on, and they're sitting right beside each other on the fucking bench.
Yeah, well, on our show, they have to figure out a way to shoot the scene so that visually it looks like we're closer than we really are.
Yeah, but that's fucked up. What I'm saying to you is, if hockey players can sit beside and basketball players sweat all over each other, do you understand? It makes no fucking sense that the rules are different for shooting a movie.
Look what happened with the Canucks, though. You know,
but that's because somebody lied, right? Went out and discombobulated the whole team.